What's up, GQ? I'm Giannis Antetokounmpo, and I'm going undercover on the internet. It's actually me. Quora. It's me, for real. Seriously. What past NBA player will be the best comparison to Giannis Antetokounmpo? I don't know. I'll say a little bit of Shaq. You know, the dominance, the getting in the paint, a little bit of magic, being able to come down the court, go coast to coast and find teammates, put teammates in the right spot, a little bit of KG, you know, having that edge, you know, that toughness, that mental toughness that nothing can break you, you do whatever it takes, and a little bit of Kobe, work ethic. I try to, you know, take a little bit of every player to compare myself with one player. I don't really know. It's a great question, and if there's a player out there that you guys think I should compare myself with, you guys let me know. What makes Giannis Antetokounmpo special? Humbleness, being grateful, how hard he competes. I'm extremely stubborn. I do stuff until, you know, I get it right. I believe in myself more than others believe in me. But if you can name just one, I'll say how stubborn I am. But I do stuff until I get them right. That's what I think makes me special. Next, how do you guard Giannis Antetokounmpo? You build a wall. That's the only way. It's a compliment. One person or two people cannot guard me. You gotta build a wall, and the whole team gotta be committed in stopping me and stopping my teammates. So that's the greatest compliment you can ever get. Next, Reddit. Why doesn't Giannis guard the opposing best player? I'm the best help defender in the league, and I think my team knows that. I'm able to cover ground. Whenever they penetrate or they try to attack, I'm able to help. I do that pretty well, but I always try to take the challenge. Whenever my name is called, I'm always, you know, up there and try to do my best. What's the most badass moment in NBA history? Oh, man. You know, when LeBron was down 3-1 and he was able to, you know, get his team together, he was able to, you know, lock in and get the job done, and it takes a lot from a leader because at that moment you feel so much pressure. You know, when you're down 3-1 and most of your teammates are thinking it's over with. I'm about to go to vacation, I'm about to go spend some time with my family, and I think he did a great job just bring his team together, try to keep all the emotions out of it and just go and compete a game at a time. And I think it didn't only take a toll, like physically, but mentally also, because he had to be in the moment. He could not think that would be the last game of the season. Could not think about what's gonna happen next. He was taking it moment at a time, in my opinion, the way I watched it, I viewed it. Next, can you believe how many ridiculous calls they are giving Giannis? Even if he's at fault, they call it against the Suns. You know, by NBA rules, I cannot, you know, talk about the officiating. Most of the time, I don't talk about officiating. I don't talk about refs, calls, and all that. I just try to control what I can control. But if I'm getting calls, I'm happy. You know, I'm getting calls. Posted. YouTube. Why are you making it sound like the guy despised super teams and was ready to guard out everyone on the teams? Guys simply said that they weren't for him. Like when I was about to make one of the biggest decisions in my life, I felt like everybody was pushing me to leave Milwaukee, and that was the right way to do it, but not for me. You know, I kind of felt like when I took that decision and signed with the Bucks, a lot of people were, you know, writing me off, writing the team off, that it couldn't be possible, you know, and I was, you know, your competitive side kicks in, your ego a little bit kicks in, and why can that be possible? You know, because I didn't go to a big market team, because a lot of people around the world don't know where Milwaukee is. I'm loyal, you know, I love my organization, I love the city of Milwaukee, and I'm a fighter. I don't give up, I try to make my environment and the situation that I'm in the best situation possible. Replied, Instagram. What's it like going from relative unknown kid from Greece to two-time MVP and NBA champ? Crazy, man, crazy. It's an unbelievable feeling. It's a lot of hard work that paid off. A lot of people that helped me along the way. You know, I'm two times MVP, NBA champ, and still, you know, it hasn't hit me yet. You know, I just put my head down, keep working, try to be as humble as possible. And, you know, when I retire, I'm going to appreciate those moments, but it just moved too fast. You know, I'm grateful for everything that have happened in my life. It's a crazy feeling, but it's not time to stop. I got to keep on moving forward. Could you complete the Cray Challenge, Giannis? A lot of people have asked me to do it, but I think that's not for me. I'm going to probably break some my bones, break some knees, break my back probably. I've seen a lot of people get injured, and I don't think the Bucks will, the organization would like to, you know, have the players doing that challenge. But if they ever tried it, I'll probably go with Brook Lopez. He has a pretty good balance. Where will Giannis Antetokounmpo rank all time? I don't know. I'm going to let you guys judge that. I'm just going to keep doing me, keep trying to, you know, make my team great, trying to enjoy the game as much as possible. And if that, you know, land me in the number 5 or number 10 or number 25 or number 50 spot, it is what it is. You know, I never underachieved, I overachieved, and I'll be extremely happy for that. What's your reaction to Giannis Antetokounmpo finally winning the NBA championship? Winning the championship in Milwaukee after 50 years, you know, there were some people that waited for this for 50 years, you know, for this to happen. And all good things take time. I was extremely happy that I was able to see joy in the other people. My teammates, the front office, my agent, my friends, you know, the people in Greece, the people in Nigeria, the people in the US, the people around the world, fans that supported the team, they really share that joy with you. TikTok. If you had to go on a dream vacation with your brothers, where would you go and what would you do? Dream vacation with my brothers, it doesn't really matter the destination. All that matters is that we are together. Most of the time, me and my brothers, we're not even in the same country. Thanasis is in Greece, Kostas is in plays in France, Alex, who knows where he's gonna play. Last year he played in Spain, I play in Milwaukee, so just we getting together is a great feeling. Giannis, you ever thought of getting waves? I tried getting waves when I was like 19, did not work out. They told me all the technique that you gotta wear a do-rag, you gotta get in the shower, you gotta put on some conditioner and stuff and brush your hair really hard, but the process was too much, so I kinda got over it and, you know, now I have long hair. Posted. How did Giannis Antetokounmpo get famous? I really don't remember. I probably think from the first time I got famous was when I went to Italy. I played a tournament with the under 20 Greek national team, and you know, that's when I kind of felt like people knew who I was, and they were pointing at me and they were like saying, "That's Giannis, that's Giannis." That's when I kind of felt it. But after the draft, when I got drafted, it kind of took off. You know, I had like 1,000 followers on my Instagram account and my Twitter account, and then that night I had like 25,000, almost 50,000. So that's when you kind of thing took off. That's when I got famous. But in my neighborhood, I was always famous. You know, I was always the funny kid. Is Giannis the best player in the NBA? No. I never want to feel that way. I want to feel like I'm always chasing something, chasing a goal, chasing somebody, chasing greatness. In the past, I said there's going to be a day that I'm going to say I'm the best player in the world, and I'm going to let you know when that day is. In my head, I thought when you win a championship, when you're the Finals MVP, when you beat everybody, that's the day when you're the best player in the world. But no. I think I got a lot of work to do. I got to keep staying healthy. I got to keep playing the high level. And there's people in front of me that have done way, 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 way more than me for the history of the game, and you got to respect that. Posted. Wikipedia. Even though he was not actually selected as an All-Star, the coaches let him play in the game as a treat for the fans. It's a funny story. You know, me and my best friend and my brother, we went to Patra. It was the All-Star game. I just went there to, you know, be a fan. And we were able to meet one of the coaches there. And he asked us, he was like, "Are you guys going to play?" And we're like, "We just came for the dunk contest." And he said, "No, you guys get a jersey. You're gonna play the game and you guys gonna have fun with us." And it was one of the best moments for us. We were around all-time greats, around Spanoulis, Diamandidis, Milos Theodosis, Sophocles Kourtsianitis. That's a great story. I'm wondering if he ever questioned if going into the NBA was the right choice. Does he still think it was? I'll be honest with you, at first I wanted to stay with my team, the team I played my whole life, my teammates and the coaching staff over there. But, you know, at the end of the day, there's people that helped me to take that right decision. They helped me to push me and tell me, like, this is where you belong. And at first it was hard. You know, I felt like the first couple months I didn't belong here. They were too fast, too strong, better than me. But whatever doubts you have, you just gotta do whatever you can do, work hard, dedicate yourself to the game. If you extremely work hard, you make them the right decision. So, you know, I made it the right choice for me. I was able to help my family too with that. Replied. Did Giannis Antetokounmpo just made the greatest block in NBA Finals history? I don't know. You know, I was just in the moment. Sometimes when you want to win so bad and you want something so bad and you've dreamed about it your whole life, your body goes to extreme to, you know, accomplish it. I was in pain. I was extremely tired, but I felt a lift, you know, at that moment, and I was able to get the block. Now, if it's the greatest block in NBA history, I'm going to let it to you guys to, you know, judge that, and we'll see. You know, time will tell. Hopefully, I can repeat it again. Which team does Giannis support? Anyone know? Growing up, I wanted to be Henry. I supported Arsenal since I was a kid, big fan of Arsenal. I think since the moment I moved to the state, I did not keep track with soccer teams. Right now, I probably support players I know. Mbappe, PSG, I know Neymar a little bit. So I probably now support PSG, but back in the day when I was a big soccer fan, Arsenal, man, Thierry Henry, that was my guy. I wonder what he considers to be his best moments. Few of them here for sure to me. My best NBA moment for me is not highlights. A lot of people don't know I'm really sentimental. One of my best moments is when my dad and my brothers and my mom came and watched me in my first NBA game and we were able to, win. It was my rookie year. We were the worst team in the league. They watched me play. They gave us luck and we were able to win the game. And I think I had my career high. I scored 15 points, I think, then. Replied. Thank you guys for your question. It was really entertaining. I hope you guys were satisfied with my answers. I'm signing off. See you guys later.